These are your top 20 shortcuts of 2025. I looked back at the hundreds of shortcuts we built this year, from shortcuts requests here in YouTube comments, the incredible ideas from over 3,200 people in my shortcuts community, what shortcuts went viral on Instagram and TikTok, many I've upgraded from your suggestions, and I'm throwing a couple new ones in too. Now, for the last 4 months since I've been using Bitly, I can actually see the amount of people clicking on shortcuts. So the top 20 is informed by this list, which it's amazing that just in the last 4 months, my shortcuts have been downloaded over 72,000 times. But I also look back at my shortcuts videos on the channel, and just from shortcuts videos, there's almost 2 million views, 10,000 subscribers, and 88,000 hours of watch time. And so first, I just want to say a quick thank you for watching, supporting, and I love that we get to nerd out about shortcuts together. And if you're new to shortcuts, or you've always wanted to learn how to build them yourself, even the advanced ones, I'm very excited to launch something new in January, so get subscribed to the channel, join my shortcuts community at shortcut.bot, and 2026 is going to be even bigger for shortcuts. But without further ado, here are your top 20 shortcuts of the year. Number one, this is called Packing List AI. This went viral on Instagram and TikTok and basically asks you some questions and then uses Apple Intelligence with ChatGPT to put together an entire packing list for your trip. So when you run it, it asks where you're going and will give you suggestions on clothing and suitcases depending on your length of trip and your destination. So let's say we're going to Alaska for 7 days. We're going to go skiing. We can choose to include other items. Also, what kind of luggage we're going to carry, suitcase, backpack, or both. And in just a few minutes, it's going to create an entire reminders list. It will be titled Packing List with today's date, and it's going to break down everything you need for your trip. Next, I did an entire dedicated video on my food tracking app. This lets you either scan a barcode or take a picture and send that through ChatGPT to estimate macros, calories, and more. I literally got hundreds of comments and DMs asking me to adjust things like the macros, what it's tracking. So the version I'll share in the video description, along with links to all the shortcuts from this video, it's going to include sodium, potassium, fiber, and even tracking water. But I'll also link my full video to the food tracking app above so you can see it in action, how to use it, and even how to adjust it for yourself. Number three, this is a shortcut I've upgraded since I shared it. I call this my Remember This shortcut, and a lot of the shortcuts I've created recently with Apple Intelligence is based on taking a screenshot. So whatever's on your phone screen, you can do something with it. Well, I've upgraded the Remember This shortcut. So if you run this while you're in Safari, it will get the full URL of whatever you're looking at. And then this is going to add that thing to remember to a reminders list. Now, if you scroll to the bottom, you can choose what reminders list you want these to be added to. And then what I do is I run this from the control center. So let's say I'm looking at something and here I am in Safari. So I know it's gonna get the full URL. I'm going to run this from the control center. I have an entire page dedicated to some custom shortcuts here, and I'm going to run the Remember This to Reminders. It's going to ask if I want to add any context, but you don't have to. Then it's going to take a screenshot, summarize what's on screen, and if you're in Safari, get the full URL of what you were looking at. Then, as you can see, it's going to save that with a little description. Title of the reminder is What to Remember, and if you're in Safari, a full link back to that web page. But this is also gonna work anywhere. This would work on a text message, maybe you're on social media. Let's say you wanna remember to follow me on Instagram, at Stephen Robles. Well, I'll go down and do the Remember This shortcut. You can add context. It'll find any URLs it might see on screen, and then it's gonna use that Apple Intelligence action to summarize it, add that reminder at the bottom, and it even adds that screenshot to the reminder so you have full context of what it was about. I'll put that version of the Remember This shortcut down below. Now, I did an entire video about Screen Time Wrapped for 2025. I also explained how it's not perfect, but if you want to get the most accurate information for your last 30 days of screen time, you can run this shortcut, no Apple Intelligence required. You can choose whether you want to do it for the device you're on or another one attached to your iCloud account. Then you'll get a quick summary of how many hours you've spent. And this is the last 30 days. If you want to log your last 30 days of activity over 2026 to get an accurate screen time wrapped, check out my video above and I'll put that link below. This one got a lot of traction on Instagram and TikTok, and it's my Find Local Food Spots. Here you can either take a screenshot if you see something on social media or select something from your photos, and it's going to use context from the image to find any local food spot that someone might have shared but maybe didn't tag the location. I'm gonna choose this image right here. It was a coffee place someone shared and I didn't recognize it. So if I tap that image, it's gonna send it to Apple Intelligence, and it's also gonna get your current location and find local spots near you. And that quickly, it found the local food spot, opened it in Apple Maps. Now I can add it to my guide, get directions and more. And this will also work just from a screenshot. So if you come across something on social media, like in a reel or a post, I'll go back to my control center, find local food spots. This time choose take a screenshot, dismisses control center automatically. will try and find any text or imagery that it can use to find the location and then open it in Maps. Was accurate once again. Next, everyone wants a method to clean up their screenshots. Well, this simple shortcut, it was one I shared just recently, but got a lot of traction on Reels and TikTok. This one gets all your screenshots from the last month, lets you choose them, and quickly deletes them. So when I run this, these are all the screenshots from the last 30 days. I can select as many as I would want and then delete them. Or you can also adjust this by expanding the Choose From List action and choose Select All initially. So when you run it, then they're all selected, and then you can just uncheck the ones you don't want to delete, tap the blue check, and they'll be gone. You can change it from the last month to the last year or the last week, and that will adjust how many screenshots you see. Similarly, if you want to clean up your photo library as a whole, I have these shortcuts that show you photos from the last 10 years based on today's date. So if you run this shortcut, it's going to show you the photos taken exactly 1 year ago on today's date. Then you can select a photo, tap delete, or delete nothing, tap the blue check, then it's going to show you 2 years ago on this date. Then it'll show you 3 years ago on this date, going back all the way to 10 years. Now, someone requested in a comment, can they see the photos a little larger and then choose to delete it? Well, that's my Delete Photos 10 Years big preview. If you run this one, now you'll see every image in a large preview. You can zoom in so you can decide whether or not you want to delete it. And then after every photo, you'll be asked if you want to keep it or delete it. I actually want to keep that one. Then you'll go to the next photo and you can choose to keep or delete. It's going to be a slower process, but gives you a better look at the photos. So both the big preview and the regular one down in the description. Now this next shortcut was before I started tracking the numbers, but I know this was huge based on the YouTube comments and all the different variations people asked for. This one lets you search for a movie and then add it, including where to stream it, to reminders. Now I've also upgraded this shortcut to pull the official trailer video on YouTube and add that link to the reminder as well. So I'm gonna search for F1. You could search for any movie title you'd like. You're gonna see multiple options here, including the release year and a little summary. Choose the movie you're looking for. After a few seconds, it's gonna show you where that movie is streaming, whether it's HBO, Apple TV, Amazon, and more. I'll choose Apple TV up here. Do you wanna set an alert to remind yourself whether or not to watch it? I'll tap no alert. And then it's going to add that to my reminders list of movies, not only with where to stream it, the title and release year as the reminder title. I can tap this and it'll take me directly to the Apple TV app to stream the movie. And also, if I wanted to watch the trailer, that's linked in the reminder as well. So I can tap any of these trailer links, like this one for Spirited, and it'll bring me right to that trailer on YouTube. Quick way to find out where to stream something and also watch the trailer. But if you don't know what movie you're looking at, like let's say it's on social media or in a reel, this next shortcut was widely downloaded, and this will identify a movie or TV show based on a screenshot or photo. Let's say you come across a little clip on social media, you don't know what it's from. Well, I'll go run the shortcut. This time I'll choose take a screenshot. It'll capture that image. And again, no text on screen letting him know what it is, but it made some guesses. Choose the one that seems the most accurate. Then it's going to give you some options from the movie database. It is actually Stranger Things. Then it's going to get the information for that show or movie and then add it with where to stream that movie or show. And it's going to add it to an ongoing note in Apple Notes with the title, where to stream it, and even the poster of the movie or show. Next, since Apple Intelligence came to shortcuts with iOS 26, being able to summarize files, web pages, and more. And if you want one shortcut that does it all, this is my Summarize Any File shortcut. You can share a video file and the shortcut will encode it as an audio file, transcribe it, and then use that for the summary. Or you can share anything like a PDF, Word document, and more. You can run this shortcut from the share sheet, or just run it right here in Shortcuts. Choose any file you would like. I'll choose a text file here. It's actually a transcript of a video. And then it's gonna create a note, title that note automatically, summarize that document, give me key points, and I'm good to go. And remember, this will also work for videos and audio files. So if I run it on an audio file, it'll download it. It'll detect that it's a video or audio file and then transcribe it. You see the transcribe action working right there. Send that transcription through the Apple Intelligence model with ChatGPT to summarize it and then create a note with a summary of that file. And in a few seconds, summary, title, key points, and you're good to go. Next, this was actually a pretty popular shortcut. All it does is find any reminders that are due today and that are not completed yet, combines those in a single text block, and then you can text it to yourself. Now you can automate this to run at a certain time of day, like 4 p.m. every day, choose yourself as the recipient, and then you can be reminded of all your reminders. So if I run this, my undone reminders are today are do the Wordle. And so if I chose myself as a contact, it would just send me this text every day. Remember, if you want to automate this shortcut or any others, go to the automations tab at the bottom, tap the plus icon. For this one, I would choose something like time of day, maybe run it around 4 p.m. You can run it daily, say run immediately, no confirmation needed or notify when run, and then just search for my undone shortcuts reminder after you download it from the link below and choose the text undone reminder shortcut right there. By the way, I mentioned my shortcuts community earlier, and I would love if you joined at shortcut.ba. You can join over 3,200 who have joined for free. If you need help building a shortcut, you can ask for shortcuts help here. I get in there as often as I can, and many in our community are actually helping each other build shortcuts and troubleshoot. Love that. If you have a shortcut you built you're proud of, you can share it in the community shortcut space. But if you become a paying member to support me and this channel, then you get access to my weekly live streams. I'm going to be streaming once again every Wednesday at noon come 2026. And you can also watch all the live stream replays where I share shortcuts before they ever come here to YouTube. You can also search my shortcuts database, get access to my shortcuts GPT that I've trained. I share a new shortcut every week and a ton more. I recently went completely independent as a creator, and so much of that has to do with all of you supporting the community. So thank you so much. And I would love if you joined at shortcut.ba. Oh, also you can get Shortcuts merch. Links to get it are on all of my videos across the channel, but you can get embroidered hoodie. You can get the create new shortcuts with the little actions on the back, women's cut shirts, kids apparel, mugs, bring in 2026 with style. Also, I'll put a coupon code that'll apply to all my merch down in the description. Good through the end of the year. Next, a little variation on the remember this shortcut. That one is based on a screenshot, but the save for later shortcut is specifically for things in Safari or maybe news articles, and it will save it to an Apple note. Now you can choose to append a single Apple note with a bunch of things that you want to save. You can also choose to add this to reminders by changing out the last action of the shortcut, but just enable the show and share sheet by tapping the little eye icon at the bottom. And then whenever you see something online, this might be some wall art I want to get, you can just tap share, then go down to your shortcuts, tap the save for later. It's gonna get a title of whatever you're looking at, images from the web page. It's gonna put that all in an Apple Notes. This way you have a bunch of context plus the full link to get back to whatever it is you were looking at. And now I have a little Apple Note, title, description, and a link back to that actual product. I find this to be more useful than bookmarks because one, if you wanna search for this later but you don't remember exactly what it was you saved, having this little summary and more context is gonna help that come up like in the spotlight search. And so if I drag down or if I wanna search for something like espresso art, now that note is gonna come up even before something like a Safari bookmark. Between the save for later and remember this, hopefully you won't have to forget anything you see ever again. Next, since Apple Intelligence came out, being able to quickly rename files based on the content of the file has become really useful. So I have two shortcuts here I'm gonna share. One is renaming files with Apple Intelligence. When you run this shortcut, you can choose any file you want. I'll go to my desktop here and choose a screenshot, which just has the normal screenshot naming. I'll tap open, and now it's going to rename that file. You can choose to add context or not. This is some of the upgrades I've done after I've shared the original version of this shortcut. Now that that shortcut is done running, I'll go over to my Files app, and you can see it renamed the file based on the content. And that was just an image. There was no actual text in that file. Let me do it one more time on a different file. I'll go to my working desktop folder. Here's another screenshot with no real name on it. I'll tap open. I'm not gonna add any context. We'll just see what Apple Intelligence comes up with. And if I go to that file now in my Files app, there it actually renamed it. That's my CES MGM reservation. Perfect. So that'll work with any files. I also have another version that will work on Apple Notes. So if you run this, you can select an Apple Note. Maybe I wanna rename this Tech Shifts. This was actually a summary of a Primary Tech Daily. That's my tech podcast, by the way. You can listen to Primary Technology at the link above. Link is in the description as well. Now, what this has to do is actually recreate the note with the content because you can't actually rename Apple Notes directly, but it's gonna create the same note with a different name and all your content is still intact. So if you wanna rename notes, you can use that one as well. Next, this was really popular in the community, Knowledge Base AI. What this lets you do is select a PDF file. So let's say you save PDF manuals, which anytime I get a new piece of gear, maybe a camera, I'll save the manual as a PDF in my Files app. Now I can select that manual, like for the Osmo Mobile 3, and I can ask questions, and Apple Intelligence through ChatGPT is gonna answer my question based on the manual that I just selected. I'll ask it, how do I record slow motion video? Now it's gonna take my question, refer to the file that I selected, and then show me the answer right here. And it will even refer to the page number where they got that answer, so I can check back at the manual, then I can see if it's actually accurate. It's also gonna say, do you wanna ask a follow-up question? Next, I shared this one around Thanksgiving, but if you wanna be able to send a text message to a lot of people, but individually, not a group message, well, you can do that here. Create a group in the Contacts app on your phone and call it something like Holidays or whatever you'd like. To do that, just go to the Contacts app, swipe over to the groups, add a list, and these are actual contact groups. So there I have my Holidays list, add whatever contacts you want there. It's gonna repeat and text this individually to each person. You can change the message here. If you want it to send automatically, just turn off Show Compose Sheet, and then when I run it, it's going to send those text messages automatically. You can also add another send message action and then include a photo or even a GIF. And now if I go over to my text messages, you'll see it automatically texted that happy holidays and I didn't have to do anything. And that'll work with dozens or even hundreds of contacts in a list. Next, I've shared a couple shortcuts on adding upcoming games for sports teams to your calendar. Well, the Apple Sports app is actually great for this. You can choose what team you want here, or it will ask you when you run the shortcut. So let me choose an NBA team. Now, unfortunately, you can't filter by league or sport right now, so you do have to scroll this long list and find the game you're looking for. But let's say Golden State Warriors are the games we want on our calendar. I'll tap Always Allow, and it's going to go through all the upcoming games, tell you who are the teams playing, the date, the time. You can choose what calendar you want to add it to, and then tap the blue check, and it will add that game to your calendar. If you want, you can even expand this calendar action, turn off the Show Compose Sheet right here, and then we'll just add all the games automatically without you having to do anything. Next, it's always popular when I share a morning routine type shortcut, and what this shortcut does is put your name here in the top text action. It's going to get 20 events from your calendars, not including birthdays or holidays, get the current weather, get your driving distance, so if you want to do this for a commute, just put your workplace here instead of Amalie Arena. It'll get any reminders that are due today, any contacts that have birthdays, and this one actually gets news items from the New York Times. You can choose a different RSS feed if you want to put that right here. And then this is going to show it to me in a quick look, but you could also have this speak text, run this from a HomePod, then have your HomePod speak your morning routine for you. And here you'll have the good morning, what today's weather is, events, reminders that are due, how long it's going to take you to commute, and the top headlines from the New York Times right now. Again, you can change that RSS feed to get news from a different source. All right, the last two big ones, being able to encode a video, transcribe and summarize it. I have a dedicated shortcut just for that purpose. This works especially well on the Mac because even if you have multi-hour videos, this is still going to work. But just choose a video file, it'll transcribe it, and it'll also add the full transcript of the video to an Apple Note as well as the summary. So I'll run this on a video file that I have in my Files app. This is a reel that I shared recently. It's going to encode that as an audio file, transcribe that audio file, summarize it. It's going to ask me to title that note. Again, you can have Apple Intelligence create a title for you if you want to add that action. I'll just choose video summary. Then it's going to create that note. And here I have the summary, key takeaways, and the full transcript of that video. And by the way, before I get to my number one most downloaded shortcut of 2025, I do want to share one new one that I've been working on. Because of a request on Threads, I found out that shortcuts can actually look at your messages content. And I find shortcuts to be able to do it much faster than even the Messages app. So what this shortcut does is ask what you're looking for. It's going to look through all of your text messages for the last 2 years. Now you can change that timing here, and then you can choose a message and see the full message without even opening the Messages app. I'll search for the word Christmas and I'm going to get a bunch of messages. And now you can scroll a list of all the messages that has that word or phrase in it. And if you tap a message, you can actually see the full message content right here in Shortcuts. Then when you tap Done, it will open that message's conversation. I haven't found exactly how to open that specific message, but get subscribed. I'm going to be doing way more shortcuts with Messages actions in 2026. And finally, my number one shortcut of 2025, and this is not only from downloads numbers, but it went super viral on Instagram. It has 2.5 million views, and this shortcut works both on TikTok, Instagram, and even YouTube Shorts, if a recipe is in the description. So you can run this from the share sheet, and what it does is gets recipes that a creator might have shared, parses it really nicely, and then creates an Apple Note with that recipe. I have a version for Apple Notes and a version for Bear. I'll include both in the video description, but this is a shortcut that's also been number one for me all year. I use it all the time. If I go to my Bear Notes and go to recipes, you'll see all these recipes that I've saved are all because of that shortcut. Now, when I come across a recipe, whether it's on Instagram or TikTok, and I see that the ingredients and steps are in the caption, I'll just go to share, share to, and then you can scroll down. There's my AI recipe to notes. Remember, you can add it even in that top row of four actions so you can get to it even faster. And in a few moments, it's gonna create an ingredient list, steps, and even a link back to this reel so I can refer to it, and it'll create an Apple Note, or Bear if you want that. And here it is, title of the recipe, ingredient list, steps, and a link back to the reel. So those are my top 20 shortcuts of 2025. Once again, thank you so much for watching the shortcuts videos here on YouTube, supporting my community at shortcut.bot. Maybe we'll get new shortcuts actions as software updates come out, and maybe iOS 27 brings huge changes just like Apple Intelligence and iOS 26 did last year. I'll put another one of my shortcuts videos right up here. Or if you just want to binge all 60 plus shortcuts videos here on the channel, That playlist is right here. Thank you again so much for watching, for a great 2025, and I'm excited what next year is going to bring as well. Happy New Year, and I'll see you soon.